Accountants deal with numbers, so they don't need to worry about writing. Right? Wrong. Accountants make their living from creating and communicating information on which powerful decisions are made. We are information merchants, and in the digital age, with increasing automation and software to handle the numbers, our ability to communicate through our words is becoming even more important in the workplace. So journalists produce news articles. Fiction writers produce novels. Accountants, our main form of written communication is a business report. So how can you go about producing high quality written communication in your business report? Some of the basic stuff you probably already know. Make sure you use headings and subheadings, write an executive summary, and use software such as Grammarly to check your spelling and grammar. Another strategy is to focus on refining and using something that we call your rhetorical moves, which is another way of saying writing strategies or signals that make your text persuasive and clear. For example, a rhetorical move might be to use evidence to support an argument, to open up a topic, or to wind down to a conclusion. When it comes to writing business reports, there are a few rhetorical moves that are particularly important. First, are summary statements, and these clearly signal to your reader what is the intent or goal of your report. These summary statements should be at the beginning of your report, and if necessary, at the beginning of your paragraphs, like topic sentences. They are important so that a reader has a sense of what you'll be covering in the text to follow. Second, business reports inform readers by providing background information and previous work, so it's important your writing signals where the information has come from. You can do this by using appropriate referencing, as well as mentioning in text if the statement you're referring to is according to the organisation, to media commentators, industry reports, or elsewhere. Third, business reports often provide a particular perspective or stance. This is because it's not sufficient just to rehash what has been said elsewhere. A good report will also help a reader make sense of it. So you might take a stance on what is the most important issue, what has been overlooked, what is the key problem, or what the solution might be. What you take a stance on will depend on the aim of the report, and this is where it's good to read your assignment instructions. The key thing is for your writing to make clear the central argument or point that your report is trying to convince the reader about. Once you've mastered these basics of business reports, summary statements, background information, and perspective and stance, then you can start working on more sophisticated rhetorical moves that are really going to make your report stand out. For example, you could start to practice ways to use emphasis to draw your reader's attention to your report's key ideas. You could highlight novel improvements to existing ideas, or you could use contrast or mobilize alternative viewpoints to show the complexity or tension or critical insight about a particular issue. You can get feedback on your use of these rhetorical moves from a program developed here at UTS called AcaWriter. You input your text into the program and it will analyze your writing and identify where you've actually used certain moves. You can then modify your text and put it in the program and run the feedback again. The program won't pick up everything, so you'll still have to use your own judgment. It's just like when you choose to ignore Grammarly's suggestion about American English, because we know here at UTS that we use Australian English. When you're reviewing your feedback from AcaWriter, think about what is and is not highlighted in your writing. And if there's no highlighting, then you need to go, have I actually used that rhetorical move to clearly signal what I'm trying to communicate? And if you have used certain rhetorical moves, have you been explicit enough? Because if AcaWriter doesn't pick it up, maybe your reader won't pick it up either. Using AcaWriter can help you ask the right questions when you're reviewing your writing, so that you can develop your written communication skills, produce high-quality business reports, and ultimately have the power to influence decisions based on your accounting information. And to clearly signal that, I'm going to have to just do this bit.